leads to a dwelling place of love. What peace and joy to feel so close to you. A heart and soul ring out their joy this morning. We long to meet you, God, the living God. The sparrow even here has found a shelter. The swallow by your altars builds a nest. Oh, happy those whose dwelling is your temple. Day by day your praises sing along. How lovely is your dwelling place, O Lord. What peace and joy to feel so close to you. Our heart and soul ring out their joy this morning. We long to be to God the living God.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, today we have the solemnity of the ascension of our Lord into heaven. Jesus ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. This feast is a feast of hope that our life does not end here on earth, but we have a privilege to be with the Father, the Son, and the Spirit in the heavenly bliss. This feast invites us not to be discouraged, rather have hope, have faith in the Lord. Particularly during this pandemic, let us not be discouraged. We renew our faith and our trust in the Lord. Today is also the World Communication Day. We use a lot of communication means, electronic gadgets, computers, mobile phones. Many different communication means we use. May the Lord bless all these means of communications. These means of communication should help us to grow in our personal relationship. But many times, these means do not help us to grow in personal relationship. Rather, they make us impersonal. We ask God's blessings that we grow in love, love of God and love of one another. As we are partaking in this Eucharistic celebration, let us prepare ourselves, acknowledging before the Lord we are weak, and ask His grace and His strength. Let us together say, I confess to Almighty God and to my brothers and sisters that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, our Virgin, all the angels and saints, and to my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins and failures, and bring us to life everlasting.
Amen.
Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy on us. Christ have mercy, Christ have mercy, Christ have mercy on us. Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy on us. glory we sing to God on high, peace on earth to all His friends. We thank, we praise, we worship Him, Lord God, our King and Father. His only Son, Lord Jesus Christ, Lord of all, the Lamb of God, who saves the world from all its sin, to Him we pray for mercy. Glory to You, the Holy One. Glory to You, the only Lord. To God be glory, Christ Most High, the Spirit and the Father.
Let us pray. Gladden us with holy joys, Almighty God, and make us rejoice with devout thanksgiving for the ascension of Christ, Your Son, is our exaltation. And where the head has gone before in glory, the body is called to follow in hope. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, Your Son, who lives and reigns with You in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. In my earlier work, Theophilus, I dealt with everything Jesus has done and taught from the beginning until the day He gave His instructions to the apostles He had chosen through the Holy Spirit and was taken up to heaven. He has shown Himself alive to them after His passion by many demonstrations. For 40 days He had continued to appear to them and tell them about the kingdom of God. When He had been at table with them, He had told them not to leave Jerusalem, but to wait there for what the Father had promised. "It is," He said, "what you have heard me speak about. John baptized with water, but you, not many days from now, will be baptized with the Holy Spirit." Now, having met together, they asked Him, "Lord, has the time come? Are you going to restore the kingdom to Israel?" He replied, "It is not for you to know times or days that the Father has decided by His own authority. But you will receive power when the Holy Spirit comes on you, and then you will be My witnesses, not only in Jerusalem, but throughout Judea and Samaria, and indeed to the ends of the earth." As He said this, He was lifted up while they looked on, and a cloud took Him from their sight. They were still staring into the sky when suddenly two men in white were standing near them, and they said, "Why are you men from Galilee standing here and looking into the sky? Jesus, who has been taken up from you into heaven, this same Jesus will come back in the same way as you have seen Him go there." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
God goes up with shouts of joy, the Lord goes up with trumpet blast. God goes up with shouts of joy, the Lord goes up with trumpet blast. All peoples clap your hands, cry to God with shouts of joy. For the Lord the Most High we must fear, great King over all the earth. God goes up with shouts of joy, the Lord goes up with trumpet blast. God goes up with shouts of joy, the Lord goes up with trumpet blast. Sing praise to God, sing praise. Sing praise to our King, sing praise. God goes up with shouts of joy, the Lord goes up with trumpet blast. God is King of all the earth, sing praise with all your skill. God is King over the nations, God reigns on His holy throne. God goes up with shouts of joy, the Lord goes up with trumpet blast. God goes up with shouts of joy, the Lord goes up with trumpet blast.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. May the God of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of glory, give you a spirit of wisdom and perception of what is revealed, to bring you to full knowledge of Him. May He lighten the eyes of your mind so that you can see what hope His call holds for you, what rich glories He has promised the saints will inherit, and how infinitely great is the power that He has exercised for us believers. This you can tell from the strength of His power at work in Christ, when He used it to raise Him from the dead and to make Him sit at His right hand in heaven, far above every sovereignty, authority, power, and domination, or any other name that can be named, not only in this age, but also in the age to come. He has put all things under His feet and made Him as the ruler of everything, the head of the church, which is His body, the fullness of Him who fills the whole creation. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia, Alleluia, Alleluia.
Go make disciples of all the nations. I am with you always, yes, to the ends of time.
Alleluia, Alleluia, Alleluia.
The Lord be with you
and with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
The 11 disciples set out for Galilee to the mountain where Jesus had arranged to meet them. When they saw Him, they fell down before Him, though some hesitated. Jesus came up and spoke to them. He said, "All authority in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Go therefore, make disciples of all the nations, baptize them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, and teach them
to observe all the commands I gave you, and know that I am with you always, yes, to the end of time. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
In the first reading of today, we heard an account of the ascension of the Lord. The disciples were looking at him and he was taken up to heaven. The ascension is an article of our faith. After the homily, during the creed, we recite the creed and declare our faith, saying, "He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father." What does this imply? What are the implications of ascension? Ascended would mean that earlier he had descended. Unless descended, he could not have been ascended. A stone that belongs to the earth, when you throw up, it comes back to the earth because it belongs to the earth. Jesus belonged to heaven and therefore he had descended. Now he goes back to the Father, ascended into heaven. Moreover, this feast implies that the mission of Jesus is complete. He has completed his mission. He has finished his mission. He had come to this world, as the Gospel of John says, God so loved the world that he sent his Son so that we may have life, life in its fullness. He gave us the fullness of life dying on the cross, and now after the completion of his mission, he is going back to the Father. As I said in the introduction, this feast is the feast of hope. Our journey begins in the womb of our mother, does not end in the tomb, but we have a place in heaven. We will be seated with the Father along with the Son in the bliss of heaven. Therefore, in Kannada it is said, Alli namma mane, illi summane. Our home is there, our final abode is there. Here we are only pilgrims. We heard the Gospel. Now in the Gospel we do not find a narrative about Jesus' ascension, Jesus ascending into heaven that we heard in the first reading. What we heard in the Gospel are the last words of Jesus, the parting words, with which the Gospel of Matthew ends, chapter 28, verses 16 to 20. We heard in the Gospel that Jesus calls all the 11 disciples to Galilee, that is in the north. Why did he call them to Galilee? Because the resurrection and appearance to the disciples all took place in Jerusalem, which is in the south of Israel. Now, after the resurrection, before ascending into heaven, Jesus calls them to Galilee, to the north. Because these disciples now have to walk back from Jerusalem to Galilee. They will have to walk back in the steps that Jesus had walked along with them. They will be going back, and as they go back, they will remember what Jesus said and what Jesus did. Their journey from Jerusalem to Galilee is a time for reflection and rumination. And all of them reach Galilee. And Jesus there addresses the disciples and his parting words. These parting words of Jesus contain three aspects. First, Jesus empowers them or blesses them. Second, Jesus sends them out with a mission. And third, he assures them that he is with them till the end of the ages. Let us reflect on these three aspects for a few moments. First, I said, Jesus empowers them. He gives his power. Luke, narrating this ascension of the Lord in chapter 24, in verse 50 says, and Jesus blessed them. Jesus blesses his disciples. That is the first action that he has before he ascends into heaven. Jesus blesses. Bless, Hebrew word is the verb barak or baraka, noun, signifies providing someone with power that will enhance his or her life. Here we find Jesus blessing the disciples. This means Jesus is giving them the power so that the disciples could enhance their life. Jesus knows that without his power, they cannot continue the mission entrusted to them. They need Jesus' power, and therefore Jesus blesses them. We have a good gesture of blessing, giving, imparting the blessings. We find priests blessing, elders bless, giving the blessings, imparting the blessings, parents giving the blessings. So this is a very good, beautiful culture that we have. Don't you think, in order to fulfill the mission, we need the powerful blessings of the Lord? Every time we bless one another, we say, God bless you. It means God's power be with you to continue your mission. We are all entrusted with a mission. I have a mission being a priest. To fulfill the mission, my energy, my effort, my strength is not enough. I need the blessings from the Lord. And on the day of ordination, blessings are showered upon the candidate so that he is able to fulfill. Hands are laid on the candidate so that he is able to fulfill the priestly ministry. Married couples are there. Don't you think that to keep your promises that you made on the day of your wedding, you need the power of the Lord, the strength of the Lord, the blessings of the Lord? Recall your wedding ceremony. How many times you folded your hands and asked blessings, beginning with your engagement, maybe later for the rose ceremony, and before you came for the nuptials, you folded your hands and asked for God's blessings. Why? You know that by your power, by your strength, you are not able to continue your mission in the family to be faithful to one another. You need God's blessings. But there are some who do not care for God's blessings, elders' blessings. Maybe because of their money power, because of their muscle power, they say, I can, I will do it. I don't care for the elders. I don't care for God's blessings. It happens. I think of the game of snakes and ladders. You know, during the lockdown, definitely you have played this game of snakes and ladder. We call it Ludo. What happens in that game? You throw the dice and you have the numbers. And as the numbers fall, you with the ladder, you go up and up and up. And when you reach the 90s, you are very happy. And then you throw the dice and you come to 99, and there is a snake that pulls you straight down to number 2 or 3. those who trust in their own power may climb the ladder up and up, but there will be a snake to pull you down. But when we trust in the power of the Lord, blessings of the Lord, God bless you, and we have received that power from the Lord, we are able to fulfill the mission, because when God's blessings are with us, who can be against us? The second is Jesus sends them with a mission. Jesus tells in the gospel of today to all the 11, go and proclaim, baptize. He sends all of them. He does not keep for himself anyone as a secretary. No, he sends every one of them. Sent with a mission. Brothers and sisters, we are all sent by the Lord. Where are we sent? To our own area to fulfill the mission. I am sent as a priest in my surroundings here. Each of you may be in the family, husband or a wife, sent to their family to continue the mission of the Lord, that we are all sent. Sent for what? The text says to baptize. Does it mean that we need to convert everyone and baptize everyone? We are accused of conversion. What does it mean? Go and baptize. We need to understand correctly. What is the meaning of baptism? What happens in baptism? In baptism, we are separated from the evil and we are united with God and one another. Therefore, we are sent with a mission of love. Separate from evil, unite with God and one another. That is the mission we are sent, for which we are sent. Therefore, we are sent with a mission of love. When we are sent for a mission of love, we need to carry only love. But many times we carry all other things than love. Our travel becomes very difficult. We have got a lot of excess baggage. When our mission is only to love God and love one another, our baggage becomes excess because of those things other than love. Many of us perhaps have experienced excess baggage in the airport. And when the luggage is more, you remove many things so that only essentials you take. Even in our mission of love, what is essential is only love. All other things like anger, hatred, animosity, hurt feelings, revenge, misunderstanding, unforgiveness, all these are excess baggage. We need to continue our mission loving, loving God, loving one another. And finally, the third thing, Jesus assures, saying, I am with you till the end of the ages. His assurance that I am with you. The Gospel of Matthew began in chapter 1, verse 23. Son will be born and he will be called Emmanuel, God with us. That is the first chapter of the Gospel of Matthew. And now the last words in the Gospel of Matthew is Jesus assuring that I am Emmanuel, God with us. He is going to accompany us till the end of the ages. The promise of God being with us is fulfilled in two ways. First, in the baptism, he gives us the Holy Spirit and we become the temples of the Holy Spirit. We carry the presence of the Holy Spirit within us. The Pentecost, the feast we celebrate next Sunday. And the second one is the sacrament of the Eucharist. Jesus' continued presence with us. Brothers and sisters, Jesus' parting words contain these three aspects. Jesus blessed, Jesus sent them, and Jesus assured them that he is going to with his disciples till the end of the ages. These three things take place at the end of every Mass that we celebrate. At the end of the Mass, the first what the priest does is priest blesses all the people present, and may Almighty God bless you, Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. Then he says, go, the mass is ended. He sends them for the mission. And we go with the presence of the Lord within us, the Holy Spirit, as well as the sacramental presence of Jesus Christ. May the risen Jesus bless us. May he help us to fulfill our mission, mission of love, loving God and loving one another. Amen. Let us now profess our faith. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, His only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day He rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there He will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Let us now place before the Lord all our prayers and petitions.
Let your response be, Lord, strengthen our faith.
Lord, strengthen our faith.
For Pope, the bishops, the clergy, and the religious, that as authority figures, they may carry out everything that Jesus requires of them as He has laid them out in the great missionary command. We pray.
Lord, strengthen our faith.
For the universal church, that it may become the visible sign of the kingdom of God, which Jesus has established through His life and mission. We pray.
Lord, strengthen our faith.
That the World Communication Day may remind us of our responsibility to live the message of the gospel and communicate it at our best of our abilities through the means of communication that modern technology is placing at our disposal. We pray.
Lord, strengthen our faith.
That the Catholic communicators may use the media to teach, inform and edify and build the faith of the faithful enshrined in the scriptures and the teachings of the church. We pray.
Lord, strengthen our faith.
For all of us present in this Eucharistic assembly, that the celebration of the Ascension of the Lord may make us zealous apostles of the good news. We pray.
Lord, strengthen our faith.
Let us now silently pray for our own personal intentions. Many have asked us to pray for them. We pray for all those who have requested us to pray. We pray for also those affected by the pandemic, those doctors, nurses, and the medical staff, the corona warriors. We pray for them that God may strengthen them. We pray for all the families, particularly the mission in the family, the love in the family, unity in the family may grow. May the children be blessed by the Lord, that they may have the bright future. God, our loving Father, we thank You for the gift of Your Son, Jesus, who being an obedient Son has accomplished Your plan for the human race. By raising Him and placing Him at Your right hand, You have rewarded Him. Give us the grace that we too may accomplish our mission as we await our reward. We make this prayer in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen. Amen. All things are Thine, O Lord. We offer Thee what we receive from thy hand. All things are thine, O Lord. We offer thee what we receive from thy hand. Blessed art thou, O Lord, Israel's God for all ages.
Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that this sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept this sacrifice at your hands
for the praise and glory of his name,
for our good and good of all his holy church.
We offer sacrifice now in supplication, O Lord, to honor the wondrous ascension of your Son. Grant, we pray, that through this most holy exchange, we too may rise up to the heavenly realms through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For the Lord Jesus, the King of glory, conqueror of sin and death, ascended today to the highest heavens as the angels gazed in wonder. Mediator between God and man, Judge of the world and Lord of hosts, he ascended not to distance himself from our lowly state, but that we, his members, might be confident of following where he, our head and founder, has gone before. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your praise as they acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving you thanks, he broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and we drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Jesus, until you come.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, Peter Paul our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection. We pray for the departed members in our own families. Bring them and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray. That with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
God is our loving Father, and it is Jesus who has asked us to address God our Father. With that courage and confidence, we now pray in the words our brother Jesus Christ has given us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread,
and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you." Look not on our sins, Lord, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other peace of Christ.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, who take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, who take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Lord Jesus Christ, Son of the living God, by the will of the Father and work of the Holy Spirit, your death brought life to the world. By your holy body and blood, free us from all our sins and from every evil. Keep us faithful to your teaching, and never let us be parted from you. Behold Jesus, who blesses us to fulfill our mission of love. The Lamb of God, who takes away the sin of the world. Happy are we who are going to receive him.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ bring us all life everlasting.
Prayer for spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Thank you, Jesus. Praise you, Jesus. Love you, Jesus.
God is good to me. Oh, what love I see. Jesus as a lamb was slain. He delivered me, cleansed and set me free. Lord of all, he rose again. Now I live, yet not I. Jesus is alive in me. Sending the Spirit's flame into my heart again. God has poured His love on me. Now I live, yet not I. Jesus is alive in me. Sending the Spirit's flame into my heart again. God has poured His love on me.
Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, who allow those on earth to celebrate divine mysteries, grant, we pray, that Christian hope may draw us onward to where our nature is united with you, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow your heads for God's blessings. May the Almighty God the Father bless you, for on this very day on His only begotten Son, pierced the heights of heaven and unlocked for you the way to ascend to where He is.
Amen.
May He grant that as Christ, after His resurrection, was seen plainly by His disciples, so when He comes as judge, He may show Himself merciful to you for all eternity.
Amen.
And may you who believe He is seated with the Father in His majesty, know with joy the fulfillment of His promise to stay with you until the end of time.
Amen.
And may the Almighty God bless you, Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in the love of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
Lightened by the word we have heard, to the world we all must go. Nourished by the bread of life, to the world we go. All together in one love and faith, seeking ever to be true, you will guide us on the path alone of eternal peace.
Along with your loving Son, bless all